What's old is new again in Milwaukee. 5 decades after streetcars disappeared from the city, they're on track to come back. 12 News' Patrick Palantonio explains that not everyone is on board.
This is what Milwaukee will look like if the plan actually hits the streets. A nearly $96 million streetcar system passing some of the city's hotspots like the Bradley Center, Convention Center, the Intermodal Station, downtown, the Third Ward, and the East Side.
It's really a monumental moment.
The moment came with a vote from a 4-person committee made up of government and business representatives. The plan they passed calls for electric-powered streetcars to come within a quarter mile of every downtown hotel room and the majority of retail, office, and downtown housing units. It would cut through Alderman Bob Bauman's district.
I think this will be a huge catalyst for economic development, especially in the Park East Corridor and the brewery.
A mix of federal and local dollars will pay for the system. Some of that money was allocated years ago, but other funding sources are still needed.
This is what I would consider a relatively modest investment into a starter line.
If the line goes in, supporters see potential for expansion to other parts of Milwaukee, and they use other cities as an example, saying streetcars will complement the current bus system. The county casts the only no vote. The concern is over competition for ridership and funding sources.
We have established federal and state programs that support the transit system, and our concern is that the system will, if not now, at some point in time potentially, compete for those dollars.
There's still work to be done. The plan will need the approval of the federal government and the city. If that happens, streetcars could be moving through Milwaukee by the year 2013. In Milwaukee, Patrick Palantonio, WISN 12 News.
The route spans 3.6 miles and costs an estimated $3.85 million a year to operate. The plan now moves to the Federal Transit Administration.